Hello everyone and welcome back. My name is Greg Furman and this is the Forex Weekly Outlook for the week of July the 16th, 2018. Now, to get started this week, we're going to begin where we always do with that all-important U.S. dollar index. Now, the dollar recovering here, the one thing I will point out that I point out with my own direct clients, what I've talked about in the live training room with VantagePoint, is that often we put in a high or a low at the beginning of each week on the Monday. So in this particular case, the dollar gets pushed lower on Monday trade, but then ultimately turns around and moves higher and closes the week much stronger. Now, I'm seeing this more often than not. The dollar still holding its ground here despite this minor retracement, very choppy in early summer trade, 94.29, 94.33, 94.45. We're closing 94.50, a very bullish close for the dollar. So when we look at trading to start the week on Monday, potentially we could be looking for the dollar to put a high in for the week, midday Monday, only to watch it turn around and reverse. So we'll be watching the vantage point indicators very, very closely here. But when we look at things right now, the long-term crossover from vantage point is certainly looking better with that long predicted area at 94.37, again with a bullish close, but we want to see by the end of day Monday if we can hold above that long pivot area of 94.37. Now, surprisingly, the equity markets are moving up also. They've recovered. We're pushing higher, holding above the key vantage point level at 27.62. But we have some very formidable resistance up here, guys. If we look at this going back to the March 13th high, right around the approximately the 28.09 area, if the sellers are going to come out, this is the area where they're going to target. Now, we could move a little bit higher, but we've still got very choppy, volatile markets. This is showing very much in the oil contracts. We've had a significant move lower. The key vantage point, long-term pivot area coming in at 69.41 has held. And I would look for oil to now start to move higher again as we move into summer driving season. Now, gold is not faring very well at all, but an excellent call here from Vantage Point. The actual sell signal from Vantage Point coming back closer to the beginning of June, the end of May. That signal has continued through a choppy channel here, ultimately pushing lower. But we do have strong support here down around 1235. And a lot of your major traders will be watching the 1200 area. But right now, by looking at Vantage Point, it says we are continuing to move lower. Now, if that is the case, that obviously is putting pressure on the euro, the very high direct intermarket correlation between the euro and gold. We put a top in, again, I will point out here, guys, we put a top in on the week on Monday, on July the 9th, and we've put a bottom in on Friday, and everything else in between is just normal day-to-day trade. We're pushing back up and challenging the Vantage Point long-term cross at 116.75. We've closed 116.83. So I would look for maybe one more pullback on the euro, and then we're likely to move higher, but we do need to watch gold very closely. The Vantage Point indicators here, very mixed, but still carrying a slight bearish tone. Now, US Swiss franc for next week, we're again coming up into a very well-known resistance area. The May 10th high here, what we're looking at, the May 10th high is coming in a high point at 1.0056. Very bullish close here, but we did pull back from exactly that top that I just mentioned here. So only a sustained break of that level will see this pair go higher. Be very cautious in early Monday trade of a false break to the upside, only for it to turn around and put a top in on Monday and then reverse the rest of the week until Friday on profit taking. So again, the indicators from Vantage Point here are showing an overbought condition. That doesn't mean it can't go higher here, guys, but really keep an eye for next week on this. On number one, the equity markets. If they sell off, that will drag this pair down. And again, the swing high at 1.0056. Now, as we go into the British pound dollar for next week, once again here, guys, very heavy support down at the 130.50 area. we're really just struggling. Once again, you can see that the high for the week was put in on Monday. I'm seeing this a lot more here, guys. And then there's no more buyers the rest of the week until we put a bottom in on Friday. And then we have a big rally only to fail at the 132.29 area, that key vantage point long-term pivot area. Indicators here predominantly are still bearish. Brexit is still on the table. This pair will continue to be choppy. I would look to continue to play the range between 133.50 and the lower 130.50 area. Now, if we can get down into that 130.50 area by mid to the latter part of the week, that's a buying opportunity, in my respectful opinion. Now, with dollar yen, we've got a good strong push. We're pushing above all the resistance area here, but we have additional resistance on this particular pair. Very heavy resistance in between 112 and 113.50, where the sellers are likely going to come out. What we need to watch here very closely is the global equity markets. If the global equity markets sell off, dollar yen will move lower off of these resistance zones. Now, when we look at it through the eyes of VantagePoint, also we can see we're in a heavily overbought condition. So if nothing else here, guys, I would anticipate a retracement back down to one of these two key VantagePoint levels, 111.53 and 111.02. If we get a sustained break of 111.02, we are going lower, and this move higher was corrective in nature. Now, as we move into our main three commodity pairs, starting with US CAD, it's basically been dragged around, but the entire range for the week, the high for the week, the low for the week, was all set on the same day, on Wednesday. I was actually working on this one in VantagePoint's new live training room, where I said we're going to basically, after the Bank of Canada, we're probably going to come down and test this known low area at 130.50, and then we're likely to extend back up to the upside. So we've got a range right now, and that range is, of course, between 132, basically 132, approximately the 132.40 area, and the 130.50 area. So what we want to watch from this particular trade is to see if we can start getting any momentum on one side or the other. Be careful with this pair on Monday. It always puts a higher low in, for, not always, but a large part of the time it's putting in a high or a low for the week on the Monday, and then it reverses the rest of the week until the Friday. So be very cautious of this. But right now, if oil continues to move lower, US Canada will go higher. But if oil is corrective in nature, which is what VantagePoint is basically telling us right now, then yet you selling US Canada into the 132.40 area is a very reasonable play. Now, as we look at our other two main commodity currencies, these two, Aussie US and New Zealand US, are not just commodity currencies, they're also equity currencies. So if the equities keep moving higher, we can see we've got a very strong triple bottom down here that's coming in at or about the 73.63 area, heavy support zone that I've talked about in last week's weekly outlook at 73.20. These areas are holding, but we're not getting past this critical vantage point long-term pivot area at 74.17. If the equity markets fail, then Aussie US will follow it lower. So if you're trading this pair, you want to watch 74.17 very closely, and you really want to keep a close eye on the S&P 500, whether it can take out that critical level that I talked about at 28.09. And essentially here, guys, New Zealand US is almost the exact same trade. We're failing at this key vantage point pivot area, 68.19. Gold is affecting this trade, so is equities. If gold turns around and follows the equities higher, and if the equities keep going higher, then New Zealand and Aussie US will both recover. But if they don't, both of these two pairs are going to be going lower. So you would trade one or the other. You would never trade both of these two at the same time. So with that said, this is the Forex Weekly Outlook for the week of July the 16th, 2018.